you can rejoice. Even when circumstances say there is nothing to love about. Anytime you realize you're struggling with the people, just rise above them. There is no charm as you go up. When you get your concern right, your research right, pray. People will be a blessing. A prayer for people.
Well, praise the Lord. I want to thank God for this opportunity He has given me that I may come and speak to you. I want to thank you so much for encouraging me and being with me for the last 3 years that I've been preaching in this telecast. Come to serve has been a blessing to many, to children, to grown-ups, in families and everywhere. And it has been a success because you have kept on supporting us and giving us good report of what the Lord is doing. Today and for the couple of weeks, I'll be sharing with you on how you can be a blessing in your generation. And I want you to stay there, listen to what the Lord is saying. And after that, please talk to me and let me hear what the Lord is saying to you. Blessings.
Okay, let's now move on. And I'll share with you three more. And then we stop there by the grace of God. And the next pitfall that you need to avoid is the pitfall I call following the agenda of your enemy. Praise the Lord. Following the agenda of your enemy. Chapter 4 of Nehemiah. When Nehemiah came, he was sure, I am coming to build the wall of Jerusalem. But when the enemy heard of what they are doing, he started giving them a different agenda. I want to say this, church. Every time you choose to do something for God, expect the enemy to rise. And when he rises, the first thing he does is to see if he can distract you by giving you his own agenda. I have come here to worship God. If your work is to worship the Lord, then you must overcome the agenda of the enemy. When Nehemiah came, he was coming to build the wall. Chapter 4. Amen. And when he was coming, he knew the call I have in me is to make sure that the people of Jerusalem are secure again. Is to make sure that Jerusalem has gone back to its glory. And when he came, the enemy arose and started giving them an agenda. And then the Bible says when Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, he became angry and greatly incensed. He ridiculed the Jews, and what was he saying? And in the presence of his associate and the army of Samaria, he said, what are these feeble Jews doing? Jews doing? Will they restore the wall? Amen. Will they offer sacrifices? Will they finish in a day? Can they bring stones back to life from those heaps of rubble burned as they are? Let's move on. And then Tobiah, the Ammonite, who was at the site, said, what they are building, if even a fox climbed up on it, he would break down their wall of stone. Now, let me ask you a question. Did Nehemiah say, we are coming to sacrifice? I'm asking you. Did you hear him saying anywhere, we have come to sacrifice? Number two, even if they sacrifice, are they borrowing anyone? Are they borrowing a goat or a camel or a sheep or a cow from Tobiah? Why are they offended? Why is it concerning them when we say we have come to serve God? Listen to me, church. Anytime you rise to do something for God, expect the enemy to rise. And because he knows we serve a mighty God, a man of war, the first thing he does is to see whether you can take instructions from him. Amen? He does not just oppose. He comes first and says, can they take instruction from me? Can I change their agenda and give them another agenda? Jesus came here, and the Bible says, chapter 4, Matthew, when the devil saw him, he said, if you are the Son of God. Now, what is he saying? I doubt whether you are. But I ask people, are you sure the devil did not hear? When the Lord Jesus, when the Lord was being baptized, the Holy Ghost saying, this is my Son. Amen? He knew. But he wanted to divert. Can anything good come from Kayole? Let me tell you, when you hear such a question, don't debate. We know something good has come out of this place. At least souls have been changed. People say in Kayole there are thugs. Is there a thug around us? Look at your neighbor. Do you see any thug here? These are our children of God. Something good can come out of this place. The media will give the wrong impression about the place. We are here to change life. And in fact, media should be saying something good is happening in Kayole. There is a man called Apostle Moridi. I tell you, he is doing a good job there. Hallelujah. People are saying every day they have been blessed. Their lives are changing. That's what media should be saying. But they will never say that for us. That's why we must say it in Jesus' name. That's why by the help of God, we must have our own media very soon. You know why? When the media says, Kayole ni kubaya, na sisi tunaleta, Kayole watu wanaokoka, wanawe sana. Watu wakisema, wao pastor wanaipia watu, tunaleta, moja wakisema, tunabariki watu. You know what? We counter once with once. Hallelujah. So this man is saying, can we give this man an agenda? When we give him an agenda, he will forget that he had come to rebuild the wall. Let me say the church. There are so many distractors whose work is to give you an agenda. That's why when you are coming to church, you must put your agenda right. I love Peter and John. They were coming to God to worship at the hour of prayer. Then they found a guy there. And this man says, give us some money, help me. And you know what the man said? We have no money. Silver and gold we don't have. I tell people it's not the truth. The real truth is the end. Because they were true Jews and they knew you don't go to the house of God empty-handed. What they were saying is this. What we have, the agenda was clear. What we have belongs to God. The enemy can position people on the way to take away your blessing. Yeah. What was Imam Atua Sema Saindia Saindia? Then you take what belongs to God and they give it out. And the Lord says you have planned the wrong agenda. The agenda when you left was that I will connect with the altar of God. Lift your hand and say, I take the agenda of God. When you came in this church, you are not coming to be fought. You are coming to be a worshiper. Choose not to fight small battles. Because those agendas are not what God has called us to do. There is a bigger agenda. And the agenda is to transform at least a life by the way I live my life. That's my agenda. Let me tell you, my agenda is clear, is to see that Jesus is worshipped. You know, even if things are, whatever I said, even if I am told all people are evil, I will still say, I know, I can raise a generation that knows that God is holy. Did I tell you one time, a policeman said, Lipa, inaitwaje, Ongo, nimpe, nikamuliza why? And I said, I'm a man of God, akacheka, and I said, my pastors have been giving. Yeah. Hiyo kitu ndio ilifanya nikachange zaidi. If you have been giving, me I will not give. Amen? So that people can say, at least there is one who has refused to do that. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nehemiah said, the agenda must remain clear. Hatujaitwa na Tobaya, tuliitwa na Yesu, na Mungu. Na hatujaitwa kusikiza sauti yenu, tumeitwa kujenga ukuta. Let us not be distracted by the enemy. Let us keep the agenda clear. Amen? Number two pitfall that we must deal with. Hallelujah. And we must overcome if we have to go far by the grace of God is a pitfall we are calling failure to discern spirits. Wow, wow, wow. I love this. Failure to do what? Every place you go, pray for discernment. Don't just accept celebrations. Makofi yote unapigiwa, usifikiri ni kushangiriwa. I read a story. Nikaona siku moja, a story between two mosquitoes. Mosquito, the mother, and the daughter. So the mother took care of the daughter. Alafu ile siku alianza kuenda sasa, akaachiriwa. Akaenda. Akapiga raundi, akarudi jioni. Aliporudi jioni, mama akamuliza, how was it? Your first day in the world. Akasema, it was so powerful. Even people were clapping for me. Everybody was? Yeah. So, hizo claps, haikuwa kumwambia hongera umekuja. Ni kumiss, alimiss kifo. Lakini akajui, akakuwa na experience. Kuna watu wamekuwa kipigiwa makofi hapa. Na unarudi kila siku unasema watu wakua na nipigia mako? You need to discern. Makofi ingine. Hmm? There are people who be saying, lakini wanataka uingie ndani wafunge mulango. Wakulia hapo ndani. That's why you should be looking. Karibu ndugu, wapi, huko? Akujeni hapa inje. You know why? You have to discern. There are some things, don't just eat because people have cooked for you. You also need to ask yourself, what have I done that have deserved this kind of a treatment? Amen. At here, ingia tukupe lift, danda. Ingia lift. Think about it. What has changed all of a sudden? They want to lift you. I'm not saying that you fear. I'm only saying that you discern. Paul, Apostle Paul, the Bible says he was going to preach and a girl followed, saying, these are the men of a Most High God. Can you imagine? These are the men of a Most High God. Ukiwa umeenda crusade. Alafu msichana akufuata akisema hivyo. Isn't that something powerful? In fact, you had just your jacket. Kumbe hata hapa najulikana. Yeah. Alafu fanyeni vile mnaambiwa. Na Mungu ni mwema alinitangulia. Lakini Paulo aligeuka akasema no. This advertisement, I did not ask for it. And they casted out the spirit out of that woman. And let me tell you, church, there are things you take as being celebrated. Lakini nakuanga ni kukumaliza. Bwana yule sana. Don't just expose yourself to some things. You need to know that you have more enemies than friends you have. I tell you, the enemies you have are more than the friends. How many of you agree with me? Usifikiri maombi yote ni ya kukuinua. Unaweza enda ukute watu wakikuombea. My friend, yesterday we were with someone. Akatuambia yeye alipata shinda kanisani. Kanisani. Akaenda akakuta pastor na viongozi wameshikana wakiomba against him. Hmm? Wakiomba, even praying that he may die. Can you imagine? Yeah. Let me tell you, church, people have gone through issues. That's why unasikianga nikileta shinda. Nikiona mutu anataka kutesa mutu kanisani. I can fight you. Spiritually and physically. Because unasumbua mutu kanisani yaende wapi. Mutu amesumbuliwa kwa mbaa. Ameingia hapa kitafuta mahali ataponea. Anakutana na mwingine na mweka teke kanisani. Where do you want that person to go? Do you know you need to think about your life? Think about what you release to people. Are you bringing them or are you killing them? Sasa mutu akaona ya atakufa. Akaenda kutafuta msaanda kwa mchungaji moja. Alijua huyo ako very powerful. Alipoenda, naye pastor akasimama. Akasema, wale watu wanashikana mikono. Wakiomba nikufe. Akasema, ya, kumbe hata huyo anaombewa akufe. Sasa huyo anakufa na mimi niombewa nikufe. Tutakaa wapi? He said he was so discouraged. Baka alienda sasa akajua sasa, I'm on my own. Maana kule nakimbilia msaanda, nimekuta huyo sasa hata huyo kwake ni kubaya. Mimi niliombewa na pastor wangu na viongozi wetu. Yeye ameombewa na wachungaji wa area. Imagine kama Kayole pastors wote, wameshikana mabishop, wakiomba nikufe. God forbid. But let me tell you, they will die before I die. Yeah. Nitazikazika watu. Na watu wengine wanazika wasema korogea leo. Because, anaweza amuka kulete shinda. Lakini tunashukuru Bwana kwa jina Yesu Kristo. I'm saying this, you may have more enemies than the friends you have. So that's why you must be very careful. Hallelujah. To discern every spirit. Amen. We were with my wife the other day. And a pastor was telling us, mke wake aligonjeka karibu kufa. Akafanyiwa all the tests. There was no doctor who couldn't tell the problem. Then he carried the wife. Waende akakufie nyumbani. Can you imagine? He had tried all things. But one night, the Lord revealed to him, ya kwamba kuna saa aliletewa a bangle and a watch. In other, when you have a bangle and a watch, you know what that means? Hakuna wakati mukono yako iko empty. Either akakako ama akakake. And the Lord spoke to her and he said, that is your death. Na bango iliingia ikawa si ya kutoa. Can you imagine? Vile ilifixiwa, hata yeye angetoa sababu kurundisha ni kazi. And when the Lord revealed to that, akaenda akakata. Hata kuongelesha mke wake sababu amelala tu aski. Akakata, akaitoa. The wife spoke. The wife got healed. The wife is still alive. You need to discern. There are things that can be done in your life. And by the way, I'm saying this, I'm not saying kutoka leo unaangalia watu wamevaa nini. No, no, no. I'm only saying you must be sensitive. Amen? Even when you are using vehicles, you don't just enter a vehicle because you are in a watu. You need to discern. Amen? Have a discerning spirit. Amen? Discern. Don't just hook up with the friends. Don't just open your house for everyone. Atieni mtu wa Mungu amepitia hapa kwa na mafuta amwage hapa. Unaweza mwagiwa mafuta ikusumbue. I'm telling you. And some of the things you hear me saying, please take them very seriously because there are people who have come back telling me, nisaidie, kuna kitu uliniambia nilifanya. Here, I prayed for one girl. Nikamwambia, na usikubali kuombewa mahali pengine. Akaenda. Kufika tu hapa kona. Akakuta mhubiri anaombea watu, anafanya andikashe vivi, wanaanguka. Hivi, wanaanguka. Akasema huyu akona power kuliko wangu. Amen. Power si kuanguka. Power ni kuanguka na uamuke na muunjiza. Ukiamuka uamuke na buvumbi, si muunjiza. Akafanyua hivi, akasema wacha ombewa, akaombewa. Alipoombewa, na ni msichana mdogo, hata kuona watu wengine, ati usiku anaamushwa na Robert Ouko wakule ugali. Yeye hakuwa yona Robert Ouko. Pasta wewe ulimuona vile alikaa. Kwa picha, huku muona live. Bwana asifiwe sana. Sasa huyo alikuwa miaka kama sita chini yako, undogo. Wewe huku muona, lakini yeye analetwa yeye kwa picha. Naambia mimi ni Robert Ouko, amuka tuku. Wanakula, anaamuka ameshiba. For 4 days, angekula, sababu aliamushwa wakakula na nani? What a blessing to eat with a minister of foreign affairs. I'm telling you the real story. Now when she came, I asked her, si nilikuambia usiombewe mahali kwingine. Akaniambia, unajua huyo nilimkuta tu kwa barabara. Kile hakutaka kuniambia ni kwamba niliona mtu wako na power kukuli. For 4 days, akuli. Sababu tayari amefanya nini? Alinifanyisha kazi ngumu sana. Namba one ya kutoa ugali. Lazima ingetoka. Amen. Namba two ya kukanya Ouko. Kuingia. And I tell you. Kumwambia kutoka leo Ouko. Na mimi simuoni. Are you getting that? Kuna wakazi tunafanyishangwa na watu sana. Ndio za ingine unaonanga mtu. Hey, let me tell you. Take what I tell you very seriously. Because if you come back here. Ni kutoa ugali. Na kuambia utaumia. Let me say this, church, by the grace of God. Let's take these things very seriously. Discern the spirits. Amen? Discern. There are people who have put themselves into problems because they did not discern. Yeah. And let me say, when you are going through a problem, it is very easy to be conned into the wrong things. Amen? Yeah. Anytime you have a need that is pressing, you need to be very careful. Because that's what the enemy uses. Yes, Wanjakula, 40 days and 40 nights, when the enemy came, he tempted him with the food. Amen? If you are looking for a job seriously, the enemy will know how to come through that. That's why you need to be discerning. If you are looking for a spouse so desperately, be careful. Naweza beba mtu nyumbani ugundue si mtu. Na sisemi uogope. I'm not saying be discerning. Chapter 6 verses 1. Are you there? Are you getting blessed? Verses 1, the Bible says, When the one came to Sanballat, Tobiah, Geshem the Arab, and the rest of our enemies, that I had rebuilt the wall, and not a gap was left in it. Wow. Though up to that time, I had not set the doors in the gate. Hey, isn't that powerful? Yani, with all the threat, tunajenga tu. Usiache kufanya kazi ya Mungu sababu ya kuongeleshwa mbaya. Amen. You need to develop a slogan. Endeleeni kuongea tu. Chekeni tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Simameni tu hapo tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Endeleeni kulia tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Because what you need is not to stop them from talking. Is to build the wall. Is not to kill the enemy. Is to build the wall. And I came to build the wall. I did not come to listen to my enemies. I came to rebuild the wall. Let's move on. Sanballat and Geshem sent me a message. This message. Come, let us meet together in one of the villages on the plain of Ono. But they were scheming to harm me. Mm-hmm. So I sent messengers to them with this reply. I am carrying on a great project and I cannot go down. Why should I let the work stop while I leave it and go down to you? Napenda watu kama hawa sana. Niko na kazi ya kufanya. Yani usikio ikuwa point. Si basi upigie Yesu makofi kwa kuwa na jamaa kama huyu. Serious. Amen. Yani wengine wanasemanga ati nikuje. Nipenda kikambiri. You have lost it. He says, I have a serious job to do. Why should I come there? And you know what he said? I understand that they have no good intention. They want them to kill me. Let me say this. Don't take yourself to the slaughterhouse. Discern. Don't take yourself there. This man says, Mimi, nina kazi ya kufanya. Don't lose your battle because of taking the wrong agenda. Discern. Mimi nasema nina kazi ya kufanya. Amen. Anytime you have no agenda, people will come for your time. You know what I tell people, Pastor? Hata ile maneno unambiangu watu suluhishe kulitokea hii, ni watu wenye wana agenda. Yeah. Any extra time, people will come for it. Just like any extra money you have, people will come for it. Like it or not. Amen. So have an agenda. Nehemiah says, I have an agenda since I came. Nimepewa leave ya siku kidogo. Na ninafaa kutumia leave yangu vizuri, nimalize kujenga ukuta. Number two, I want to see the people, my fellow Jews, wamesimama awadhalauliwi. That is my agenda. Na sasa nimemaliza kujenga, sinjaweka ukuta. I don't have time. Tobiah na Nehemiah na Sanballat, muko na kazi ya masaa ya kuharibu. Mimi sina, ni leave. Nimepewa. Na mfalme ananingoja. Look at somebody mwambie, kuwa na agenda. Discern the spirit. Yeah. This is a spirit. This is somebody who is taking the place of a priest, of a prophet. Amen? Yeah. Na unajua, tukijaribu kwa mambo ya mengine yote, na tumeshindwa, tumekuita hoteli au kuchi, tumekuita kwa vali au kuchi, na sababu we ni mtu wa Mungu, wacha tujaribu kama tunaweza kushikia kanisani. Do you see this spirit, Pastor? You have to discern them. Because they even take the form of godliness. Inakaa kama ukweli. Maana, where else can we get help? It's in the house of God. Amen? And then these men are saying, there is a conspiracy to kill you. And please, let's go hide with you in the house of God. Let me say the church. Even if the house of God is invoked, discern whether it is of God. You can be killed in the house of God. Nehemiah discerned. What did he do? Let's read some more. But I said, I love this. Should a man like me run away? Ah, pause. Ah. Kumbe kuna lugha tunaongeanga na tujuangi ni ya Biblia. Mwanaume kama mimi. Ni wa kutoroka. Mimi nataka kuweka watu tu maasira tu kuwasaidia in life. If nobody is encouraging you, jitia mafuta, kanyanga mafuta. Sema mwanaume kama mimi ni wa kulala njaa. Mwanaume kama mimi ni wa kuharakishwa. You know what? I love Nehemiah. Na si kiburi. Hii ni kuongea ukweli. Or should one like me go into the temple to save his life? I love Nehemiah. Hai. Yani mimi. Wengine wakijificha kanisani. Mimi ni mtu wa kujificha kanisani. Mimi ni mtu wa kukutana na wao pale uso kwa uso. Bwana asifiwe sana. There are levels to walk with God. And you know some things are not optional. Alafu hao watu wameanguka mtiani. They should have known this is Nehemiah. A man who has served in the king palace. He has seen things. Kuna mambo unapitianga baka na Mungu. Inakusaidia. Ukisikia shinda, unakutana nayo. Because you have overcome so many other things. May God hand in your life in Jesus' name. When you discern a spirit, don't run away. Decide to attack it in Jesus' name. Have a discerning spirit. Amen. Discern. Don't just hook up with the friends. Don't just open your house for everyone. Atiye ni mtu wa Mungu amepitia hapa kwa na mafuta mwage hapa. Unaweza mwagiwa mafuta ikusumbue. I'm telling you. And some of the things you hear me saying, please take them very seriously. Because there are people who have come back telling me, nisaindie, kuna kitu uliniambia nilifanya. Let's take these things very seriously. Discern the spirits. Amen? Discern. Discern. There are people who have put themselves into problems because they did not discern. Yeah. And let me say, when you are going through a problem, it is very easy to be conned into the wrong things. Amen? Yeah. Anytime you have a need that is pressing, you need to be very careful. Because that's what the enemy uses. Yes, Wanjakula 40 days and 40 nights. When the enemy came, he tempted him with the food. Amen? If you are looking for a job seriously, the enemy will know how to come through that. That's why you need to be discerning. If you are looking for a spouse so desperately, be careful. Naweza beba mutu nyumbani ugundue, si mutu. Na sisemi uogope. I'm only saying be discerning. Chapter 6, verses 1. Are you there? Are you getting blessed? Verses 1, the Bible says, when the one came to Sanballat, Tobiah, Geshem the Arab, and the rest of our enemies, that I had rebuilt the wall, and not a gap was left in it. Wow. Though up to that time, I had not set the doors in the gate. Hey, isn't that powerful? Yani, with all the threat, tunajenga tu. Usiache kufanya kazi ya Mungu sababu ya kuongeleshwa mbaya. Amen. You need to develop a slogan. Endeleeni kuongea tu. Chekeni tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Simameni tu hapo tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Endeleeni kulia tu. Lakini kazi inafanya nini? Because what you need is not to stop them from talking. Is to build the wall. It's not to kill the enemy, it's to build the wall. And I came to build the wall. I did not come to listen to my enemies. I came to rebuild the wall. Let's move on. Sanballat and Geshem sent me a message. This message. Come, let us meet together in one of the villages on the plain of Ono. But they were scheming to harm me. Mm-hmm. So I sent messengers to them with this reply. I am carrying on a great project and I cannot go down. Why should I let the work stop while I leave it and go down to you? Napenda watu kama hawa sana. Niko na kazi ya kufanya. Yani usikio ikuwa point. Si basi upigie Yesu makofi kwa kuwa na jamaa kama huyu. Serious. Amen. Yani wengine wanasemanga ati nikuje. Nipenda kikambiri, you have lost it. He says, I have a serious job to do. Why should I come there? And you know what he said? I understand that they have no good intention. They want them to kill me. Let me say this. Don't take yourself to the slaughterhouse. Discern. Don't take yourself there. This man says, Mimi, nina kazi ya kufanya. Don't lose your battle because of taking the wrong agenda. Discern. Mimi nasema nina kazi ya kufanya. Amen. Anytime you have no agenda, people will come for your time. You know what I tell people, Pastor? Hata ile maneno unambiangu watu suluhishe kulitokea hii, ni watu wenye wana agenda. Yeah. Any extra time, people will come for it. Just like any extra money you have, people will come for it. Like it or not. Amen. So have an agenda. Nehemiah says, I have an agenda since I came. Nimepewa leave ya siku kidogo. Na ninafaa kutumia leave yangu vizuri, nimalize kujenga ukuta. Number two, I want to see the people, my fellow Jews, wamesimama awadhalauliwi. That is my agenda. Na sasa nimemaliza kujenga, sinjaweka ukuta. I don't have time. Tobaya, na Nehemiah, na Sanbalat, muko na kazi ya masaa ya kualipu. Mimi sina, ni leave. Nimepewa. Na mfalme ananingoja. Look at somebody, mwambie, kuwa na agenda. Discern the spirit. Yeah. This is a spirit. This is somebody who is taking the place of a priest, of a prophet. Amen? Yeah. Na unajua, tukijaribu kwa mambo ya mengine yote, na tumeshindwa, tumekuita hoteli au kuchi, tumekuita kwa vali au kuchi, na sababu we ni mtu wa Mungu, wacha tujaribu kama tunaweza kushikia kanisani. You see this spirit, Pastor, you have to discern them. Because they even take the form of godliness. Inakaa kama ukweli. Maana, where else can we get help? It's in the house of God. Amen? And then this man are saying, there is a conspiracy to kill you. And please, let's go hide with you in the house of God. Let me say the church. Even if the house of God is invoked, discern whether it is of God. You can be killed in the house of God. Nehemiah discerned. What did he do? Let's read some more. But I said, I love this. Should a man like me run away?
Kumbe kuna lugha tunaongeanga na tujuangi ni ya Biblia. Mwanaume kama mimi. Ni wa kutoroka. Mimi nataka kuweka watu tumaasira tuwa kuwasaidia in life. If nobody is encouraging you, jitia mafuta, kanyanga mafuta. Sema mwanaume kama mimi, ni wakulala njaa. Mwanaume kama mimi, ni wakuharakishwa. You know what? I love Nehemiah. Na si kiburi. Hii ni kuongea ukweli. Or, should one like me go into the temple to save his life? I love Nehemiah. Hai. Yani mimi. Wengine wakijificha kanisani. Mimi ni mtu wa kujificha kanisani. Mimi ni mtu wa kukutana na wao pale uso kwa uso. Bwana asifiwe sana. There are levels you walk with God. And you know some things are not optional. Alafu hao watu wameanguka mtihani. They should have known this is Nehemiah. A man who has served in the king palace. He has seen things. Kuna mambo unapitianga baka na Mungu. Inakusaidia. Ukisikia shinda, unakutana nayo. Because you have overcome so many other things. May God hand in your life in Jesus' name. When you discern a spirit, don't run away. Decide to attack it in Jesus' name. Let me tell you, nobody gets a mendo by running away. Amen? You must slay your giant. If you want a gift, a prize. And the Bible says, this man says, no, I can't do that. Then he says, I will not go. You see, you're arrogant. That is not being arrogant. Iyo ni kuamua, unajua kile unataka. I'll not go. You know what? Every bridge you cross, you must fortify yourself. So that usirie machozi ulilia ukiwa mtoto. That's why you can say, a man like me, I have seen things. Amen. Natembea na Mungu. Kuna level. I love one preacher saying something here. Akasema, hata nyinyi wadanda. I'm glad she was a lady speaking to ladies. Akasema, hata wewe, ufike mahali wa mwe uli. Ni kuamua, si ya machozi na kaukanga. Machozi ikauki, na ukitaka kuamini iko tu guza na pilipili, itatoka. Ni kuamua, unaamua siri. Pana kwa sana. kwani utalia mpaka lini? Unaamua. Kuna watu tu wanakuanga tu kuongeleshwa vibaya. Mzee amechelewa. Amekataa chakula. Akikataa chakula, kula. Weka kwa fridge. Usilie, bwana yule sana. I'm telling you the truth. There are levels you walk unakuwa 100. Amen. Mimi nataka hii kitu ingie ndani ya mtu ndio narudia hii. So that wherever you go, kifanya mtihani unauliza man like me can I fail an exam? Amen. Hiyo inagutia ukiona ukienda interview unajua utapita. You pass before you go. Refuse when you discern that something is not of God, please decide to oppose it. Yeah. Do you know there are things you know outrightly? This is not of God. Don't come to ask me. Jo kuna watu wanatakanga kitu unajua si ya Mungu lakini unataka kusikia nitasemaje. Even if I don't say anything, you have already discerned this is not of God. Amen. Hallelujah. And then I finish by saying this. The third pitfall is rewarding your opponents. And I'll finish at that. Rewarding your opponents. Nehemiah. Thank you, Jesus. Chapter 13. The Bible says, when he finally finished the work and he celebrated that the Lord has been good to them. Chapter 13, the Bible says, when he went, he came back later and he discovered there was a mess somewhere. On that day, the book of Moses was read aloud in the hearing of the people, and there it was found written that no Ammonite or Moabite should ever be admitted into the assembly of God, because they had not met the Israelites with food or water, but had hired Balaam to call a curse down on them. Our God, however, turned the curse into blessing. When the people heard this law, they excluded from Israel all who are foreigners of a descent. Now, if you read also Genesis 19, 36, you see also something about these two people. They were the product. They were sons, Ammon and Moab. They were product of Lot and his daughters. When Lot's wife died and he ran away with his children, Genesis 19, the Bible says, one night they gave their father beer, wine. He drank, and the first daughter slept with the father, conceived, and gave birth to a son. And the second one said, wow, if it has happened, she also made the father drunk, slept with the father, and got a son. And that is the generation. And this is the generation also that fought the children of Israel, and they fought them so seriously. Now, the Bible says, verses 4, but Eliashib, the priest, and put in charge of the storeroom of the house of our God, in the house of our God, he was closely associated with Tobiah. Do you remember Tobiah? Tobiah ni nani? Is the man who fought the children of Israel. He is the same man who sinned. Ile kitu anajenga hapa, bwana yule sana. Ata bwea akirukia itaanguka. Are you seeing that? He is the same man who planned how Nehemiah and the Jews will be executed. He is the same man who asked, will this sacrifice again? This man, the Bible says, he was given a room formerly used to store the grain offering, the incense, the temple articles, and also the tithes of grain, new wine, and the olive oil prescribed to the Levites, musicians, gatekeepers, as well as the contribution for the priest. Can you imagine? What a mistake, says us India. the people, the enemy who oppose you, all of a sudden is given a key post. God, do this surely. Why should he give to a man who opposed even sacrificing a room that was supposed to be, where the sacrifice was supposed to be kept? And this man was not happy. And the Bible says, verse 8, I was greatly displeased, and they threw all Tobiah's household gold out of the room, and I gave orders to purify the room. Nehemiah alikuwa mtu serious. Ioshwe na ipigwe marashi kwa sababu mtu alitupangia kutuua, akatutumia threat, akatusumbua, amekuwa akikaa hapa. Ioshwe na ipigwe marashi. Kusiwe na harufu ya Tobiah. Kwanza ziwe sala. Do you know even in your life Tobiah can occupy that room? Akusumbue sana. I pray that the spirit of Tobiah will never hinder your progress in Jesus' name. Because these are people who oppose you from the beginning. But then when you start succeeding, they say, we have been praying for you. Those people can bring you down again. You need to be discernful. There are people who will always oppose you doing something. But the day you start succeeding, they become friends. Na unasema kama ametubu ni sawa. Kutubu mupatie brotherly love, but not a post in your life. Bwana asifiwe sana. Am I speaking somebody here? There are rooms that you must never give your enemy. Attack your coca. Apewe brotherly love. But the post like this, don't. And you know Nehemiah? I gave orders to purify the room. And then I put back into them the equipment of the house of God. Can you imagine? Uyu mutu wana andabu. Anatoa vitu vya Mungu. Dialale hapo ndani. Amen. Unakasirikia umutu, brother Gerald. Mutu hana andabu. Vitu vya Mungu viondolewe. Mwenye aliopos kujenga, alale hapo ndani. You see, I keep saying, infiltration is the worst thing the enemy can use. Is to come inside and fight from inside. Afadhali andui wa inje. Sasa huyu aliwapiga, akawapiga, finally akaenda kwa priest. You know Eliashib. Eliashib, nafikiri sababu ya ronzuri ya kuani. Akaona kama ametubu ni sawa. Ni sawa aende biguni. Lakini kwa nini unampatia hii post? Pahali pesa ya Mungu inawekwa. Pahali vitu vya Mungu vinawekwa. Why? Why should we displace the things of our God? Listen to me, church. Even our heart as compartments, you must never allow anyone to remove the things, the room that the things of God stay in your house, in your heart. Iyo ikae, intact. Amen? You know, your heart as compartments, keep the place of God very secure. That you can tell people, I never compromise anything that touches my faith. Amen? I never compromise. Anything that has to do with my faith, I never compromise. Tuonge ingine lakini hiyo, wachana nayo. And you know what happened? The Bible says, I also learned that the portion assigned to the Levite and not be given to them. And all the Levite and musician responsible for the service and gone back to their field. So I rebuked officials and asked them, why is the house of God neglected? Then I called them together and stationed them in their post. I want to finish there and saying this. Every time this spirit enters the house of God, something happened. Number one, it speaks to people against giving. Discourages people from giving. Did you hear that? Yeah. Discourages people from giving. Because when there is no giving, that's why Tobiah said, will they sacrifice again? That was the first question he asked. Will they sacrifice? Now, they have even sacrificed. Akasema pana, let me occupy that land, that house, where they keep it, so that they don't give. Na ile iko ni kule. I say this, church, anytime this spirit enters the church, people don't give. And when people don't give, what happens? I tell you the truth. Let me tell you the whole truth. Pastors suffer.
Amen.
They will suffer. Wanasema akuli yangu. Sio nzuri. Sio nzuri. Ainanga baraka. You know, we have had to save some pastors from embarrassment. Kwa sababu kanisa watu wamesema atutoi. Ata ni mwanaume afanye kazi kama wanau. When that happens, Brother Jeremy, ukweli ni mwanaume ataenda kazi. And that's what the Bible says. Nilienda nikakuta the work of God is neglected. Why? Because what we are sema, kwa ni yesi mwanaume atafute kazi kama sisi, akaenda kutafuta. But what happens? Let me tell you, when the priest leaves the altar, people suffer. It may look okay in the beginning. In fact, you can even quote scriptures. Amen. We are a royal priesthood. We are all that. It is true. But there is an hierarchy and an order that God has established. When that order is messed up, people suffer. Let me say the church, the giving number one in the house of God, the Lord said, give your tithe that there may be food in my house. Amen. He is a giver. So he wants to raise men like him. And when he sees a giver, he says, wow, now I have one. But the point number one, Mwalim, you must bring your tithe so that there is food in the house of God. So that mimi nisiende kuomba chakula. Maana hata Daudi alisema sijawahi ona mwenye haki akiachwa na Bwana ama akienda akiomba nini chakula. Kwa sababu ni madharau, by the way, the first level ya kudhalauliwa ni kuomba chakula. Yeah. And that's why I tell you, if anyone ever borrows food, mpe. Mtu akiomba chakula ni kusema mambo ni serious. Amen. Kwa hivyo ukiona mchungaji amefika kiwango ya kuomba chakula, kuna shinda. Na shinda ya kwanza, Tobaya ameingia mahali. Tobaya ameingia. Na Tobaya alijua, hawa watu wakiingia wa sacrifice, something will happen. Now they have sacrificed, something is happening. So what do I do? Ingia hapo. Kataa wasipewe kitu. Amen. I taught some pastor somewhere. Nikaona wabili wameumia sana. Why? Because they have a treasurer ambaye pia kwa na roho ya Tobaya. Alipochaguliwa kuwa treasurer, he became the God watchdog. Pastor asipe pesa ya Mungu. When Tobaya enters the church, people suffer. Na mimi naomba, Tobaya akae mbali sana. Na Tobaya ikiwezekana akufe. Kwa sababu anaishi kufanya nini? Ametusumbua tukijenga. Ametusumbua. Na sasa anataka kuingia ndani. Let me say this. As we serve God, we must be bold enough to deal with some spirits. Even in your family, we must deal with that. Tobaya can hinder money that belongs to the family from getting into the house. Inakuliwa tu na vitu zingine. So that you may suffer as a family. I declare in Jesus' name. Any finances, any money that is supposed to land in your family shall not be stolen, shall not be eaten by the wrong people. In the mighty name of Jesus, Tobiah must never be allowed to eat what belongs to your children. Lift your voice and say, I declare in the name of Jesus, any money that is mine, that is supposed to benefit my family, shall never be stolen, shall never be eaten by Tobiah and his people in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's all stand up before God and make a prayer. Hallelujah.
Wow, praise the Lord. I believe this message has been a blessing to you. You have been blessed, and probably you are there. You have never given your life to Jesus, and you want to give your life to Jesus today. Please pray with me this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. Forgive my sins and write my name in the book of life. You are praying that prayer? I want to say, the Lord bless you. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you for my viewer who has just given his or her life to Jesus. I pray for them, Lord, and I pray that you keep them and bless their lives and let them enjoy the blessings of walking with you. In Jesus' name, the Lord bless you. I also want to extend my invitation to you. Please come tomorrow at 10 and worship with us at Gospel Celebration Church, Kayole. We are in Kayole 1 and opposite the City Council Clinic. Come at 10 and I can assure you, you'll be blessed. I also want to welcome you to buy my books, Come to Serve and Leadership Pitfall. These are very powerful books that I have done myself. Please make sure that you call and buy these books. God bless you and shalom.
Mana masete, lito sete, risite krisa tata, rise krite zata vata. Mana masete, zileva mama masete, te 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 va.